السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We are in Lizergab area in the north of Khartoum with sister Rida and brother
Ahmed
Abdullah. And you can see in this area alone at least 15 to 20 houses, properly built houses of bricks, and others have been destroyed totally. And the people wake up at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock in the evening to find that their house is being covered by water. They lost their furniture, as you can see the furniture here, and they lost their property, their clothing and everything at that time. So really the flooding was unexpected and unimaginable at the same time, because this never happened in Sudan over the last 100 years, when a flood like this come and cover more than 17 out of 18 districts, cover more than 500 square kilometers of agricultural land, and destroying more than 120,000 houses in the whole country. And this is the second year in a row. 2019 was another flooding at that time, which covered 16 or 15 districts out of 18 districts. I was talking about it earlier on, about the flooding which came here. It's because of the negative effect of climate change, which is happening from the new industrialization, which does not have any care or any consideration of the people who are living in the globe. And this is because of the rising of the sea level, the rising of the temperature, and the production of the carbon dioxide emission, which is mainly by two superpower countries, industrial countries, United States of America, as well as China, to affect Sudan, to affect Horn of Africa, which include Tanzania, Kenya, Somalia, even West Africa like Niger, even Pakistan, Afghanistan, and other countries as well in Africa and different parts of the world. So this kind of flooding, which happened once in a century time, it's because of our ignorance or our ignoring the negative effect of climate change and the increased amount of carbon emission from the industrial states, who are refusing to be a part of the climate conferences in the global ones, inshallah. The people here, there are about 15-20 houses have been destroyed here in this area, but more houses have been destroyed in different areas. People only need from you how to help them to build their houses again. They don't want you to help them in food or anything else, because they can be productive, or they are productive farmers and workers in the country. Just what they want to rebuild their houses only, to live in safety, to live in dignity, and to be a credible individual citizen of the country of Sudan. Please help them, because Sudan is not on the radar of the international media, unfortunately, and we need you through your social media and through your communication to raise the awareness of the plight of the condition of the people of Sudan 2 months after the flooding. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.